Sharon's case, we heard of so many things are happening. And now the Pumwani Saga. Welcome to Kuza TV, our campus talk show. I am Valerie.
Vivian.
And I'm Wash.
So today we're talking about the Pumwani Saga. Do you think it's very nice what Governor Sonko did of just going to the Pumwani hospital unannounced?
I think the Nairobi governor, he acted way too late. Pumwani has a lot of issues, mismanagement, so I think he acted it.
So, according to you, Mwash, do you think this is something that has just been happening over the years and this is just now the time that it's now been discovered?
Okay. Let me put it this way. There's no way at any point you'll put 12 kids on bags and you tell me it is the first time. No. That means it is something that has been happening. And even in the interview, the doctor said that we did this because we don't have a mortuary. So that means it is something that has been happening. And funny enough, there are evidences and cases of people who are claiming that I've never got my kid. My kid died when I was delivering and
happening over the years.
Now, that something that amazes me is that one of those cases is actually a very prominent lawyer in Kenya who delivered in Pumwani and still up to date hajaijua kwenye mtoto wake alizikwa.
So it's something that has just been happening. Yeah. And do you think that Governor Sonko just sacked four directors? Were there four directors or how many were sacked? So do you think it was a good thing or it was not according to the law?
Okay, like, whatever the number was sacked. I think yeye mwenyewe anafaa kujitoa kazi kwanza before you sack the others.
Because he's even the one in charge. He's the governor of Nairobi.
He's the governor. And how do you sack them? Because they put, okay, I don't support that. I don't say that putting 12 kids in the bag is a good thing. But generally, a hospital like Pumwani, a hospital that has existed since time in memorial, and
I hear even the president was delivered in the same hospital.
And you tell me it doesn't.
So by then, there were still no facilities.
Yeah.
So if this case was not put into the spotlight, even the governor himself, hakuna kitu angefanya. So,
funny enough, it is not something that imekuja tu out of nowhere. I think there are some politics being played there. Because generally, kama ni kitu imekuwa ki happen for so long, why was it not discovered before?
So what else could have they done?
So what are they
generally
managing?
They could have done nothing.
So why are they there?
There is Pumwani, and days back, Pumwani was one of the best. And it was a place where those people that
the
like politicians and what have you used to deliver and what have you. But
prominent.
Today, Pumwani is for the not even middle class, but
the lower class.
So, generally, who is the case ya mse kama Uhuru? Uhunye imepatikana huko wazi mtoto wake amezaliwa Pumwani? No. So, what is happening and the reason as to why hata Sonko mwenyewe akitoa au watoto is because hata bibi yake Sonko yeye mwenyewe hawezi enda kuzalia huko.
So that it's just political games and all that. So you are linking it to politics. And who could be playing this
politics same thing as
on who?
Telling me, kesi ya Sharon kutapatikana mwenye aliwana.
But
that is the same thing.
I still don't get where politics is entering in this case.
That is why I'm asking myself, what kind of Kenya we are living in right now? Because generally I've heard of another case that boy child is being sold at 10,000 and
same,
a girl child
in the same hospital.
In the same hospital.
Yeah.
And the girls are being sold at 50,000.
Why?
No.
Why would the boy child be sold at 10,000? Anyway,
no,
you deserve
the
it. The boy child, you're useless.
Okay, let me ask you one thing. Let me tell you one thing. You ladies, let me tell you.
And you're so stubborn when it comes to
relationships. Let me tell you what you'll do.
Yeah,
exactly.
Let me tell you what you'll do. You ladies.
No,
let me tell you what you'll do.
That.
men go and live. Go live in a world without men.
That's
and
even the directors. Most of them, they're also men. So
if you were, if you had some value, you couldn't have been sold at 10,000.
Okay.
Create a world full of gulchard only, and let us live alone, and let's see how you'll survive.
The world will be so perfect.
Anyway. Whatever the case, whether we are being sold at 10,000 and you are being sold at 50,000, generally selling a child and mark you, it is not the director's
kids. I can now agree with you.
It is not the director's kids, but those women who are going to deliver them.
So if this thing, I get you to a spotlight, I don't get you these things.
As I'm kidding, what will you do?
Me personally, I think after it will your ear will see for you.
It won't be closed. Right now, we are discussing this. Uh-huh. Right now, there's a woman who has given birth at Pumwani. There are many waiting. In line waiting. Uh-huh. So generally, there is Kenya. That is how we have to live.
No, but
and we'll do nothing about it.
We don't have to live that way. You know, there's we can change.
What will you do?
What I'll do, Sonko, even though he acted way too late, what he did was very nice to sack the management. Because the managers are the ones who are responsible for everything that's happening, if it's not a mess that happened.
Exactly, they're the ones who should report case of any.
Okay, according to me and according to what I think, Sonko, do this. Make sure all the directors that were sacked and the doctors that were sacked are back at work. That is one thing. The next thing, make sure that Pumwani has equipment. Because generally, you are sacking them. They don't have the equipment. So what did you want them to do? So what you did was just but a foolish thing.
But you also
Sonko himself?
Yeah.
Of sucking the director.
Yeah, because Pumwani is still running and at our kikufa wataiko kwa hizo kibins. Why? There's nothing, there's no equipment.
The health sector in Kenya is not.
Yeah, also another thing on Pumwani is supposed to have 150 nurses, but only 5 to 6 work. Five work in the morning,
where are the others?
Six, where are the others? Who is to blame? The management. That's why I support the Nairobi governor. What he did, sacking all of them.
Anyway, the case is out of our hands. Let Sonko do his work. Don't just sack. Do what is supposed to be done.
And we'll have a better
Thank you all for joining us.
With lesson.
Till next, when are we meeting? Is it Friday?
Friday, we'll have us our next show. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank
Until. You.
Don't forget to like, comment, share,
and subscribe to our channel,
Koza TV, Nurturing Talent.
Follow us on Facebook at Koza TV, Instagram, Koza_TV, and Twitter at Koza TV.